Welcome to the first game of the, well, White Wolf Palace Nomad Bonanza. Now, White Wolf Palace, of course, is a professional team from China. A lot of well-known players here. And just the other day, they were online and they were playing a lot of team games together. And I picked the best ones here to show you today. And these are all on Nomad as well, so get ready for that. I will introduce the players as soon as the town centers are all going up, which they are. So let's do that. And how are you doing, Fidel Castro? Good to see you, man. Let me introduce the players really quickly here. In the... Well, let's start with orange here. In orange, we have Jibatong playing as the Mongols. And an interesting TC spot as well, right next to water. Good luck farming around that one. In the purple, we have Paladin playing as the Dravidians. Ooh, the new civilization. In the red, we have Mr. Yo playing as the Japanese. Very good. And then in the yellow, because that's also the team, we have AOEII playing as the Magyars. AOEII. Oh yeah, we actually haven't seen him yet, so there you go, AOEII. In the teal then, right next to him, it's Bad Koala, and they're probably going to have a bad time, as you can see. This is, wow, and he's in between gray as well. Look at that, Stray Dog right on the other side. So this might actually be the worst freaking TC spot ever. You're far away from your team, and you're in between two pro players with little access to resources. And of course, the laming starts right now. Well, it's not technically laming. It's, everyone can take these boars after all. And it's, teal. Using the house trick to make the boar de-aggro for a second. And here you go, takes in that boar. As the town center just goes up, and now yellow finds out, as teal takes the second boar as well. Look at that, takes both boars at the same time. But now, of course, you're going to have to kill both of these on the UTC without making them walk back too far. That's risky. It's risky. Shoot the other one as well. Oh, teal wants to get this boar. Oh, it's going to go back. Oh, gets it though. Gets it. Oh, as yellow is going to try to block that, but he cannot stop the boar from going here. Yellow really wants a boar as the boar gets killed. But close enough to Teal's TC where he won't be able to, where Yellow won't be able to, what's the word here? Obstruct Teal from taking it. Alrighty, well, like I said, this is gonna be hectic. Anyways, in the blue we have Vivi playing as the Burgundians. And then last but not least, we have Lix here in the green playing as the Portuguese. Now I noticed that only one of the colors is off, so if you don't mind me, I'm gonna change the colors to reflect the team game colors. So I'm gonna make Paladin blue, if he is okay with that, and then we're gonna make Vivi, we're gonna make him purple. So we're just gonna switch the colors around a little bit, just for clarity's sake. Which, wow, and see, this is why. I thought they were actually on the same team over here, all together, but I guess that's not the case here. There you go. So Paladin is also kind of in between enemy team members. So there you have it. Those bastards, first they took Blast Furnace for Lithuanians and the Nomad maps from us, right? Bastards. Yeah, I'm still sore about that one, Lithuanians not having Blast Furnace anymore. I don't know, man. I just really enjoyed having Paladins with 18 attack, you know? It was just fun. Not so much for the opponent that had to suffer 18 attack Paladins running through their town. But it was fun. Wait, was it 18 attack? It was more. No, it's 18 plus 4. 22 attack, is that right? Now I'm second guessing myself. See, it's been so long. I don't even know what it was like. Jeez. As Yellow now finds Gray's town center here. Yeah, it's gonna let them know as well. I also noticed that Yellow, is he docked anywhere? Well, whatever happened, looks like Gray tried to dock on this side, and Yellow denied that with a wall. Also killed the villager, I think. Yeah, I think so. Yellow got a kill, and Gray lost the lost something. Must have been a villager. As Gray's gonna try to complete that dock anyways. Yellow didn't wall this corner though, so Gray can still get it up. Got it, see? So that wall doesn't do anything. No! What? But you can build through corners. What is this? Yeah, so Gray's gonna delete it. Well, I guess not now then. Docks are so weird then, I guess. You can't attack around the corner of a dock. I guess you can't build the corner of a dock. But what madness is this? Or is it maybe because it's Yellow's walls he can... No, but I remember games distinctly where you could still build a castle even though it was walled in on all sides. So weird. Okay, well, in any case, Yellow denied Gray's dock, so I guess that's pretty good. Yeah, Yellow's docked all the way over here. That's pretty sweet. We have Yellow building an outpost right next to Teal's TC, but Teal can shoot that down, right? If Teal's gonna... is gonna commit to that, of course. Now, it's of course a question, what is Doity going to do here? Because he's stuck right in between two other players. Like, this is a terrible start to be in a Nomad. And you kind of need to hope that you can keep your fish alive long enough that you can get the food from that, because farming is not going to be that much of an option. As Yellow actually finds a boar and happily takes that in. That's the kind of food that he definitely needs here. So yeah, it's good that he found a boar there. Also Xing his enemies for his team, so the rest of the team knows, yo, I'm going to be in trouble here. Now, Teal's fish is right in between purple and red, so it wouldn't surprise me if red and purple will destroy Teal's fish, which, of course, is not good for Teal, because he needs that fish just as much as Yellow needs it. So there you have it. Now, I must say, like, green's position is fairly good. I guess orange's position is fairly good as well, because it's far away from blue, at least. And you can still cross to the other side. So that's fairly sweet as well. I like Green's position also because he has docks in his central lake, which no one else has. So he has some free fish that he doesn't have to defend. You know, it's always a kind of a give and take. There's less fish in these kind of little inland seas, but your opponents are unlikely to dock it, which means that you have some safe fish if, of course, you protect it. I mean, it's not like your opponents can dock this inland sea as well. We have Yo killing a greenhouse, because why not, right? Why not? As he also scouts Green's DC now. Green could shoot that down, but yeah, the villager's gonna get away now. Very good. Update on Yellow and Teal. Still a stalemate. This is an ongoing turf war, that's for sure. It's just gonna get worse as soon as we get to the feudal age, that's for sure. As the two villagers start clashing here in the north, Yo and Lix fighting, which is always funny when Yo and Lix are, you know, in the opposing teams, because they're such a great team together. I really remember when they played the 2v2 World Cup. What a fantastic performance from these two players, honestly. Like, if you haven't seen those games, seriously, watch the games. Like, Lix and Yo together are a masterful team, you know. As said, there you go. Yo, gating out Lix's villager, gets a villager, and now he's gonna have to run away with his own vill. Very messy. Weak villager sent back home. Very nice. On 2 HP, one more hit and would have gone down. And red is just gonna have to abandon this attack, I'm sure. Yeah, he got too close to the town center. Now you definitely have to run away. Still more HP for red, though, so he still could fight with some good Michael. Can still fight. Here's red. But yeah, look. I mean, green is just gonna abandon this attack now, I suppose. As, yeah, red hits the castle and instantly drops a tower on a wood line that green was no longer using. But green does have stone. Will be able to drop his own towers later on. As we have, like I said, Teal and red were probably going to fight over the fish here. As you can see, red now attacking Teal's docks. Looks like Teal's fish has, it's skedaddled out of here, as you can see, to safer havens. Now, blue walled out orange for now, which I think orange will probably be fine with. Especially since, and blue will be as well, because blue will want to focus on red, who is right on a hill to the south of his base. At the same time, he's also busy dealing with green. As green is forced to fight with villagers, now going to wall this out so the towers can't continue. Another tower going up on the stone. That can't happen. You can't let him get that stone. Green, you're going to have to counter tower, rush it down, something. We may not have noticed it yet. That tower will go up. We have yellow has one villager in here to continuously attack this house. It's more so to be a nuisance, I suppose, rather than really annoy them. Yeah, as green now notices that a tower has gone up on his stone. So yeah, at this point, if red walls it in as well, no more stone for green, that's for sure. Yeah, look, red is going to wall that in. Very good. Not that green can't rush it down, but he'll have to delete a house at that point, which is not ideal. We have yellow now also being, will be put under pressure from the left side as well from gray, who has gone up quite late. I think gray is looking to get a fast castle here. He's on gold as well, or is just going to make some military. He is here with villagers as well, so we'll see. And yellow is on stone, as he should be. You know, you want to be able to build towers, as you can see. Tower going up in a very important woodline for teal. Important, because it's its only woodline, and he can't see the tower. Good stuff. Then on green, he's moved to another lumber camp right now. Still, yeah, he's going up. Is he going up to the castle? Is going up to the castle, but does he have enough stone for a castle? That's the question. No, doesn't, because he was kicked off his stone. That's a big deal. He might have to buy it then. I mean, he has the gold, so I guess there's that. He's gonna let Red get this tower up, and I guess maybe castle right here to shoot down all these towers, perhaps. That could be a thing. Yeah, a tower going up from gray, contested by yellow. But, of course, yellow's tower does not go up, because gray is actually making some military here. Some Hun cavalry and spearmen. Alrighty, then. As yellow is, it's a tricky world to live in. Tower does go up, so yeah, Teal will have to relocate his lumber camp. As red is now gonna drop a tower on green. Interesting. Is that gonna go up? That's one villager that is not building it right now. Are there more villagers being sent over? Not that I see. That's purple. Oh, that's purple. Never mind. That's purple dropping a tower now on green. Oh, poor green. He's gonna get pushed further and further inland right now. He's gonna need his own tower. Let's see if he's gonna... I bet he's gonna buy one as soon as he gets to the castle age. And, yeah, castle tower instantly. Oh, if that goes up, though. It's gonna get more tricky and tricky. And it, of all the people, I thought green was gonna have an okay spot. You know, with the fish and all, you know, far away enough from his opponents. But as far as red and purple are concerned, nope. Nice castle there for orange on a hill on a gold, you know, attacking, threatening these walls from blue. So I'll probably have to pay attention to the left side. At the same time, expanding to the west because probably, you know, Jibatong is going to have the most safe economy out of the game. As we have yellow now defending with some scouts. Of course, the spearmen making that a bit difficult. The villager here could go down, but of course, the scouts push away. Great scout. A knight now from yellow here, which is definitely a lot stronger than these freaking scouts. Yellow is still alive for much longer than I thought. The fact that he has his fish alive as well definitely helps. His team is winning on water for now. And Teal does not have active fish at the moment. One fishing ship over here. So that definitely doesn't help. As a result, Teal, not in the castle yet by a long shot. He's making galleys right now. So Teal is not going to be able to contribute on land. So it's going to come down to gray. Can he snuff out yellow, or will yellow hold on against both these opponents? While yellow for now is pushed off of his gold by the knights from gray, which is a big deal because there is no gold for yellow to be taken here anywhere else. Unless he breaks through Teal's town, which is probably what the plan is right now. As you can see, town center going up. Which there's no villager underneath here, so you can just run. Yeah, you can just run right underneath it. Yeah, Teal didn't have any villagers here, so you can just run right through the town center. This is good stuff for yellow, that's for sure. Wait, what? Oh! Hang on a sec. We have a dock here from blue. That was his starting dock. And a villager has been building a siege workshop. And now suddenly, orange, who thought he was the one putting on pressure on the other side, now has to deal with elephants in his town. And I think he just realized you need to fight this. That he's fighting against these elephants, but the downster is gonzo. There you go. That is over. But of course, these elephants are trash against, anything melee. Because they don't, you know, they have very low attack, as you can see. Like, it's 5 attack. That's not a whole lot. Villagers will be able to fight that. There you go. So, I mean, Orange did take some damage there. Lost his starting TC, for one. But he has his TC to fall back on. In the meantime, Green is still alive. But his TC is about to go down here. Yeah, it's, Red is building half a wall over here. He's going to try to tower over here, but there's organ guns right now. Defending that, of course, that's what Portuguese are very good at. Organ guns are a great unit. I really like organ guns, actually. Steel is sniping fish in the north. Man, this is hectic. We now have purple helping his teammate yellow by attacking gray on the right side here. Of course, gray very busy with attacking yellow at the same time as yellow tried to drop a TC on the gold, but that failed for now. Villagers were sent to the west to build a house, but now, boom, you're going to get that TC up and yellow will have gold again. Very important moment here. Well, will he? Yeah, that should go up. Should go up. Yellow, gray's knights are distracted in the south. That downstairs is going up and then, boom, the villagers are safe. There you go. This is important. That was really important, actually, because now yellow is gold again. He can actually make knights. At the same time, purple will be harassing gray on the right side, distracting him as well. Down system for Teal has gone down at this point. I think Teal... actually, he deleted it. He deleted it, and he's rebuilding it up here. But Teal is now going to try to reboom a little bit. He's definitely the furthest behind out of all the Lixus team... Anyway, as the Custodier is still making life for Grey hell as the Grey Knights are trying to chase that down. Yeah, Purple is going to back up now. Keep his army intact. And of course, these Kutsuniers have pretty bad base attacks. As soon, you know, it's just 8 attack. That's not a lot. But that first hit does a lot of damage. And that sometimes it makes all the difference in the world. Bit of an engagement here on water with blue and teal working together. Of course, these galleys, they fire faster than war galleys. So actually, galleys aren't that... You know, they're not as weak as you think. But they go down to fire ships really quickly. So that's their main weakness. Now fighting in Gray's town as well, as Yellow is helping with knights, and suddenly Gray is the one under siege, and Gray is the one who has no army to defend himself. You know, definitely making life hell for him. I must say, this might be, like, this was one of the worst starting positions for Yellow that you can imagine, and he's actually the one who is coming off the best out of the bunch here. That's fairly ironic, actually. We have blue and Orange is shooting at each other. Well, actually, Orange's castle is shooting at Blue, but Blue is not doesn't have the range. Didn't get the ranged upgrade, so he can't do that. Another downset now for Yellow on the stone. Wants a castle probably at some point. As he's trying to save his Mangonel. Yep, very good. That's good stuff. And Gray's gonna have to think about relocating, which is what he is thinking about, as you can see, because there go the villagers. And I wonder where they're gonna go. As Red actually went to water in the middle, just to make Green's life even worse. Like, Yo is just trolling Licks at this point. He's just trolling Licks. As Kusiliers are raiding the line for Green as well. Not something that he reacted to at this point. And yeah, it's just... It's starting to look really bad for Licks and Steve all around. Like, the only one who's still kind of intact is Paladin. But Gray's had to run. Teal's had to run. He's still in the Feudal Age, actually. Hasn't gone to the next age yet. He's expanding his economy, as he should. But it's gonna take a while, for sure. Yeah, Blue's the only one who still has an intact economy. He's still working with these faster firing elephant archers. That's the bonus that the Ravidians get. Elephants attack faster, which includes elephant archers, which is pretty sweet. But they do lack some armor, which means they fire. You know, they do a lot of damage, but they are not as tanky as other elephants are. As you notice, against Mangudai, still no contest. Honestly, Mangudai are definitely the better unit. You know, because you can pick fights, run away, things like that. A green force to go further and further back to the east. But yeah, of course, the Kusiliers with their spear hanging around, ready to snipe at will. Yeah, if you look at the vill count, it's 232 right now for Mr. Yo's team. Only 167 for Lick's team here. So you notice that it's starting to snowball a little bit. Especially now that Gray's base is going to get eliminated as well, which means Purple and Yellow can start supporting each other. Teal's already not an issue anymore. Orange is right. Good if he finds this economy, which he hasn't found yet. He could definitely put pressure on Teal as well. Teal's lucky that Orange hasn't seen this yet. As Gray's going to mine stone, something that Orange can actually see. So he won't be able to see that. Because the castles are shooting at each other now, but one castle has the hill, so that's much better. As Orange is besieging this town, the starting TC here for Blue. I think it was the starting TC. It might have been this one, I don't know. But in the meantime, dropping a castle now to protect himself in the north, because Blue is, well, has been putting pressure on Red this entire game as well. But not to the point where Red couldn't go and troll a green. Green is still trying to hold on with what little eco he has. Is actually going up to the Imperial Age so he can start trapping down these castles, which is a big deal. That might change things a little bit. Like, Portuguese can do this. Low eco, organ gun push, very strong. We have Orange probably realizing, hey, there's someone taking my stone. That means that there might be some presence of the enemy right here. And actually, Yellow just spotted Teal's base here. So now Teal's been found out. And I wonder if Orange is going to deal with that. We'll see. He's going to send his military south. Although Blue is stonewalling this out. Not knowing that there is a land bridge to the west here. Does Blue know that? He does know that. Okay, well, he should know then that this gate is not going to do much if he doesn't wall that either. The elephant's raiding a wood line, but yeah, they just go down so quickly. Go down so quickly. Lacking a pierce armor is a big deal. You might have HP, but against the Mangudai, have a high damage output. Yeah, Spray's running away with his last villagers in his town. But where is he going to go? Where is he going to go? He can't run to purple, as we have stone walls. Alrighty then. Well, we had some random stone walls from Gray just to annoy Purple, which I guess did the trick, because Purple is trying to take down the stone wall with villagers, which might take a while. As wait, who converted a blacksmith? Looks like Mr. Yo is converting some buildings here, which means he could. I mean, he could delete them, but why would you, right? You can just use them. Shoot down the palisade wall. As blue is gonna have to defend himself, build another castle to keep himself safe here in the middle. Very good. But yeah, he's being surrounded from two sides now. And if you know your history, you know that being on a two-front war is it's no bueno. That's not really fun. Most empires try to avoid that, with some with more success than others. Yeah, purple still is going to send his troops to the north now, as Teal actually makes it to the castle. It's very nice, and instantly drops a few more town centers, which is important. A castle also from Orange. Oh boy. Orange wants to stop this right now. He's noticed that, okay, there's enemy economy here. Let's snuff that out before it starts. Purple is going to run out of Custeliers, making sure that Teal can't do anything. And Orange is just going to drop a castle. And Teal, who just expanded to a new world, is already getting raided once more. At the same time, we have a trebuchet now coming out from green, but Purple is gonna dive that and kill the trap here while sending in some battering rams of his own. Green dropping a castle now on a hill, even further back, you know, to protect himself a little bit more, as the first castle is being rammed down by battering rams. Not something that Green can actually do that much about. Orange guns though, fire. Oh. Pretty sweet. But it looks like the GG is called, and it looks like Lix's team is bowing out, probably after seeing that Teal and Gray are both losing their economy once more. At that point, it's pretty much too late. You know, they need a reboom. You know, Blue wasn't able to kill either Red or Orange here, so he's kind of stuck in between. And Green was holding on for dear, clinging on to dear life. So yeah, the first one goes to Mr. Yo's team then. We can have a scoreboard, right? I think the team stayed the same, so let's turn on that scoreboard. Let's enable that. There you go. It's a best of 4. There we go. Return the map, and then the first game goes to Mr. Yo's team. Yeah, it goes to Mr. Yo's team for a mess up. Very nicely done. That was hectic. I am surprised how well Yellow handled this in the being in the middle. Like, he was between two players. I mean, he had help from his team, most certainly. But being in that position, with your enemy towns that are right here and then right here, that's too close for comfort, honestly. But in the end, Yellow managed to win with the help of Purple and also Red, certainly, killing Teal's fish early on, slowed Teal down significantly. Teal didn't get to castellate until quite late in the game, so that definitely didn't help. Yeah, so... Of course, Purple did a great job putting pressure together with Red on Lix here, making sure that he was also ganged up upon. And then Blue, yeah, he was fighting against Orange, and that was basically a 1v1 that was fairly even. I think Orange definitely helped by the fact he had expanded his economy to the west here. So, now, quick look at the statistics here. Well, I mean, the military difference definitely started to play a role here. Especially Orange and Purple were starting to, like, get a lot of military out here. There's Dark Custeliers, no joke, still. You know, they might not be the best unit in the world, but they can certainly make a difference. Especially if your opponent does not have any military. Or little so. Okay, he's not too pretty for most of Lex's team. Ooh, Grado. Oof. Yeah, I mean, he didn't have a lot of kills anyway, so it's not as bad as it looks, but still, best KD looks the, or most kills here for Purple, it seems, with those Custeliers. Good stuff. Also, best economy in the end had to, you know, was the furthest away from enemies and was able to boom the most, I'd say, followed closely by Blue, who had kind of a similar situation. Yeah, in any case, GG. That was game number uno. Let's go for the second one, shall we? Because again, these games kept coming, and I kept saving them, because they were good ones. So, it is of course going to be, I think it's going to be the same players as well. This one is, you'll see for yourself. You'll see for yourself. I'm not going to spoil anything. So, let's go. Yeah. And, there we go. Perfect. Alrighty. Well, welcome to the second game here between Team Lix and Team Yo. Let me quickly change the colors here. Looks like Vivi once again in the wrong color. Yeah, we'll make him purple. And Paladin needs to be green. Alrighty, that way it's team colors. That's easier to see. There we go. Everyone Xing their TC. Very nice. Looks like all the TCs are going up. So let's introduce the players once more and see where they are. In the teal here, let's just start with Lix's team. We have Lix playing as the Ethiopians. Very nice. In the gray, we have Stray Dog playing as the Mongols. Then in the green, we have Paladin playing as the Burmese. And in the blue, we have Bad Koala playing as the Bengalis. Interesting. Haven't seen Bengalis yet today. As for the other team, in the red, we have Mr. Yo playing as the Portuguese. In the yellow, we have Doidi playing as the Bohemians. In the orange, we have Gibbeton playing as the Vikings. And in the purple, we have Vivi playing as the Mayans. Of course, Vivi likes his Mayans. Now, I think that's one of his Chinese sock puppets or Smurf accounts or something like that. Now, I can't read these characters, but I've looked it up, you know, the AKA, just to be informed. So I know who is playing here, you know, because if it's a famous Chinese player, I'd like to know. In any case, looks like an interesting map. This is pretty standard, actually, you know, that you have this inland sea and then one crossing from one side to the other. You know, it creates a nice dynamic. I like how this branched off, actually. That's kind of interesting. You know, if you want to wall this from this side, you have to wall two sides instead of just one end, like you can do here. We already have a little bit of an engagement here between gray and red here, as Mr. Yo does, without Loom, is going to lose that villager, which is a big deal actually early on, killing that, losing the dog villager, because that is a bit of food that you're missing now, of course, besides losing one. Of course, Lix and Yo are really close together, actually, something that Lix just found out. Yeah, he sees that. Does Yo know this? Yo doesn't know yet. Yo doesn't know that he's right next to Lix, so that might be some trouble, actually. Lix knows this, which means he can use that to his advantage, like pushing in the deer here, as you can see. That's what he's doing with the villager. Or maybe taking this boar from Red, because Red doesn't have a whole lot of boars, actually, if he's... Actually, there's no boar. This is the only boar that Red can actually take reliably. You know, this one is kind of far away. Steel's probably going to get that one. That's the risk of being right next to someone, is that... There's not a whole lot of boars. Actually, you know, normally there's more boars near the coast, but I guess in this case, not so much. Boars spawn very far away, so fish is going to be very important for these two players. Now, for green and yellow, kind of a similar situation, especially green. It's kind of isolated. You know, he's kind of in this little peninsula, as you can see, which it's nice defensively, but it means there's less resources. Like, for example, if green loses this woodline, that's it. That's the only one he has right now. He'll have to go somewhere else. As yellow is going to find green in a second. Yeah, green's trying to kill the villager. But yeah, yellow notices that. He's going to run away. Now he knows, hey, that's green. We should pay attention to that. Green's going to have a bad time, though. He's pretty much on his own. And there's three of his opponent right in the line here. So he's going to have to fight a defensive action for sure, Paladin. Bad Koala is on the wrong side of the map as well. But at the very least, he's far away from his opponents. And then, of course, we have... Gray and Teal both on this side together, so they can work together against Mr. Yo. As Mr. Yo is going to try to get a boar now. Alright. That's something that Lix could see, actually, if it gets into the fog of war. Yeah, you can see it now. I think Red will get that boar. Yeah, there's no way that Teal can stop that, so that's good for him. And he needed that boar. Again, like I said, that's the only one that he could really take. Is Lix to send a village around and shooting these deer, making sure that some food rots away from that. Hold on just a second. We got a boar being attacked by Lix now, walling in his villager. Very nice. So that boar is now definitely his. As Red is going to try to break through the wall. The palisade wall. As Lix de-aggroes the boar. Yo tried to de-aggro the boar. And now Yo's gonna steal it. He stole the boar, so now it's his. Interesting. Oh, is he gonna get the boar though? Lix sending a villager now. He's gonna try to stop that. Let's see if we're gonna get a gate or something like that. Yeah, here's the gate. Do block that. Force that villager to go to the west here. You don't have time. You do not have time to kill a gate here when there's a ferocious boar chasing you. As now this boar is gonna go after Lix, because now it's attacking Lix because Yo de-aggroed it to save his villager. Yo though, with the gate block at the same time, the boar is still aggroed against Lix, but Yo is walling it out. The boar cannot go to Lix as it dies on the stone right in the middle here. So then who gets the boar? Because it's not close enough to Lix where he can... defender, but it's DC, but it's close enough to Yo that he can still think about taking it, which he actually is. As Lex is not happy about that, he's gonna try to wall it out, and now Yo is fighting. Now I think peace is over right now. And Lex has the boar, and Yo says, no, this is my boar. I killed it. You go away. Wait, did he kill it? I think it was Lex that killed it, actually. As Lex is trying to wall it out, now you have more village from Yo. The HP is exactly even, but it's closer to Lex, so he can easily send reinforcements here. As, yeah, one villager from Lex kind of weak, Yo trying to block it a little bit. They're not even eating the boar right now. They're just fighting with villagers. As there's still a villager from Lex that's running home, kind of weak. She should be very careful. There's a ferocious mob of Yo villagers here that is looking for Lex villagers, just like that, to kill. As Lex is trying to block the red villager, but ends up blocking his own villager, as we have half the economy from both players chasing each other to fight with villagers. Yeah, Lex doesn't want to run away that far away. So he's just going to run away with one villager, and the rest he's going to send home. And in the meantime, these villagers probably don't even know what the war started over. You know, it's like, what were we even fighting about? Oh, right, the 300 food and the boar. And Lex takes the boar. But Yo is still not done. Yo is still not done. He's like, that's a lot of food. I want that food. I don't want you to have that food. So go away. And the right of the strongest prevails. And now Lex is sending more villagers because he wants that boar. He really does. And we haven't even been looking at what's going on the other side. Looks like green got walled in almost, and he's sending villagers to the north. That's smart. We need to keep an eye on that. But actually, why would we look at anywhere else? This is the fun stuff happening right now. Who's gonna get this boar? I mean, in the meantime, food is rotting away, so I mean, time is running out. At some point, there won't be any food anymore, as Yo is sending 14 villagers against 10 from Lix. So Lix sends 3 more villagers, and it ends up with an even HP as well. Because some of these villagers from Yo are kind of weak, although Lex has a weak village there as well. Ugh, this is really messy. How do you micro that? How do you micro that? One villager from Yo goes down. Uh-oh. Oh, now it's on. Now it's on. Now it's on. Yo is very unhappy about that. Gets a villager, and now it's even. All right, there you go. Eye for an eye, villager for a villager, as they say, huh? Yo's running away. At the same time, Yo finds another boar. And Yo, of course, Lex is going to try to stop that as well. Trying to de-aggro it, and does de-aggro it, and now he gets the boar. Oh, these two. And in the meantime, they're still fighting with villagers, mind you, as Lex is just running to the right now. He's just going to kill that boar, I guess. He starts to quick wall his villager. In the meantime, still microing his villager as well. Let's go, micro. There you go. Nice. Walls in his villager, shoots the boar. Nice. So Yo can't have it. All Yo is taking this one, and Lex, again, is going to have to fight for this one. Both these players are not going to go up to the feudal age anytime soon. They are very busy right now. And so you still have villagers fighting, but Yo is taking a lot of food right now. He's eating his boar, but of course, because he is taking the boar, has less villagers to fight. So Lex has more HP right now. Actually, no, I lied. No, Yo still has the upper hand, but Lex has a hill and kills another one of Yo's villagers. How long is this war gonna last? This villager fighting war, man. Like, this must be so stressful. Both players are just trolling at this point. Just having fun. I gotta love it. Yeah, this is the stuff that Lix lives for, by the way. This is the kind of stuff that he lives for. But Yo likes it messy as well. So they both like this. It's just so much fun to see these two players, you know, compete against one another. Or compete with one another. They're just phenomenal players. What can I say? As Red cannot get too close to the town center. This is, of course, the big advantage Lix has. Now he's sending 19 villagers against Yo's 10. And almost has double the HP. So yeah, Yo is definitely going to have to rethink trying to take this boar here. As the villagers are fighting once more. And we haven't even looked at the rest of the map yet. Teal has some villagers down here as well that he's not working right now. He actually, someone X'd the villagers, said, Yo, you can fight with these. As another one of Red's villagers bites the dust. Yo definitely has to be careful now. He's fewer villagers here. In the meantime, though, this boar is still rotting away. Lix is not getting it either. And that's it. 4 food. So in the end, Yo probably wins this. Lost villagers, but he got more food out of it. So I guess there's that. And there you have it. The boar is done, though. As Lix has killed this boar on the right side. Can wall that in as well. So Yo definitely can't have that food anymore. And I think that should be the end of the Vil War here. As Yo is going to send his villagers home. And we'll have to find a more creative way to get up to the feudal age. In the meantime, his team is going up to castle age, just so you know. Like, other stuff has happened in the meantime as well. As green is trying to get a tower up as well, but here comes yellow, who's probably going to drop a castle, isn't that so? Yep, that's a castle. That's a castle coming up. I mean, he doesn't quite have the stone, bought some stone, there you go. A castle, that will shoot down this tower for green, and green is not going to be happy about that one. Lix is doing it, so he lost the fishies. And hi. Ooh, how are you doing, Varys? Long time no siege, man. Wait, did he lose his fish? Oh, didn't he? Did he? Looks like he did. Oh, Lix is screwed. Lix, but then there is, of course, there is a stray dog who was here as well, as the vilt fight is still continuing. Guys, the boar is gone. There's nothing to fight over anymore. Stop it. As Red is gonna get castle dropped. So in the end, even though Lix has no food and will have to farm, Yoru's gonna have to run away with his villagers. Jeez. This is some fun nomad here, right here. I told you, it was awesome. As I said, this fancy Bohemian castle did go up. Of course, Green's villagers all got shot down here. The tower will get shot down in a second. Well, one villager actually makes it out. Look at that. Yeah, so Green's not going to be in a good spot. Honestly, Green's position might be worse almost than Teal's position. Like, at least Teal is somewhat safe now. You know, Gray's going to keep him safe. You know, it's red for Teal, so it's even. But then Green, he's just going to get pushed out of his town by Yellow and the rest of his team eventually. He's going to need some help from Blue at some point. And at the same time, Green's going to lose his fish as well. He's trying to run with his fish, but that's a big deal. That's a big deal. That's even worse than for Teal, because at least Teal can farm. Green can't do that. Now he's just surrounded on all sides. But he did find Red's villagers now. Going to try to wall that out a little bit. Try to wall the villagers and trap them somewhat. But yeah, there's still a hole in the north, so... As the Arambai are chasing down these vills, but Arambai, their attack is so scattered that it's hard to kill villagers like that. As we have this one Hussite wagon, which will definitely do well against the Arambai because of the pierce armor, the HP. As we have some Gibbetong ships being sent to the north to finish the fish here for Blue as well. Bakuwal is going to lose his fish as well. I think he will be okay with that because he can farm. You know, he's got four town centers pumping villagers right now. You know, he can extend his farming economy. He'll have to. He just lost his fish. Same thing is probably going to happen over here to Green. Yep. Alex is still in Dark Age, though. I mean, even at least Mr. Yo made it to Feudal Age, you know? At least Mr. Yo made it to Feudal Age. Lex is still, he's just farming Dark Age farms right now on Nomad, which is always a good sight to see, huh? That's a plumed archers coming out right now as well. Still green, still mating a little bit with yellow. I mean, luckily he has a castle here himself. That saves him for now, but he can't take this stone. He can barely take this gold. And of course, this peninsula, Now again, it's easy to defend, but you can easily get walled in as well. So Green should definitely think about sending some villagers north. Yeah, exactly. Get some villagers up there as well. Which Yellow is, he's tracking that down. He's trying to find where those villagers went. I bet he saw that. You know, he must expect things like that as well. As Teal walled up, is farming out here as well. Hilarious. You might better hope that Yellow doesn't find that, because Yellow will just roll his suicide wagons right into town. That's kind of what they're for. As Purple is using some plumes to raid around, it's going to also put pressure on Blue's town now with a siege workshop. Good stuff. While Purple is also, still has some navy around, has fish safe, and has the most safe and secure spot on the map. So Purple can do whatever he wants, and honestly. You know, Vivi is going to be happy with his mayans. As Green losing that villager that he sent forward, it got walled in by Red, and Yo killing Green. Alrighty. Fire ship, the fire galley, I guess. Looks like Gray has a battering ram randomly going around. I think that was used to kill Red's town center, or his buildings down here, I think. Although Red at this point, probably, he might have also deleted it, I don't know. He just rebuilt it over here, keep himself a little bit safe. Oh boy. Well, Green is going to have to expand to the north, so it looks like Lix's team is going to have to move over here as well, while Blue holds on. This little bridge, this bridgehead in the west. Good stuff. Okay, well, I guess the game kind of settled down a little bit, but definitely a heads up for Yo's team here. They have more villagers, a more secure position. Also, they still have fish, and, you know, which is a pretty big deal on this map. You know, looking at all their fish, yeah, they still have all their fish going. Especially for Yo, that's a really big deal because he has all the fish in the world now, so he can get his economy, you know, back on track. More easily than Licks, especially when Hussite wagons, like I said, rolled into town and are making life hell. Of course, one of them is not that much of a threat, but still. Other than green, still can't farm. Like I said, losing fish was a big deal, because he can't farm for nothing. Yeah, so a villager actually goes down to gray, who was, yeah, purple tried to save it, but that didn't work. Alrighty. Yeah, well, purple obviously well, he's planning on putting pressure on blue for now. As, ooh, it looks like some plumed archers got wrecked by the mangonels here, which he's telling his teammates, like, hey, there's mangonels, can you kill those? And orange is like, say no more, fam. And he kills the mangonels, even dodging the mangonel shots as well, where he can. So, yeah, so blue's just gonna try to repair that, run away. Alright, yeah, well, I mean, how hectic things were at the start of this game, it's kind of peaceful right now. I don't know. You know, they kind of died down a little bit. A shot from blue misses with the mangonel, though. Purple, very risky. You're going to sit right next to the mangonel. Shot from blue, but no, a shot from purple. Perfectly timed. Lands. You know, and even if it wouldn't have insta-killed the mangonel with the damage that the plumes were doing, that definitely made the difference. A shot from blue. Purple dodges it. It's going to go for the repair village at the same time. Fearless is purple as he micros right in here, and ooh, Bad Koala is losing a lot of villagers here. Bad Koala, he can't do anything with his mangonel right now because the plumes stay right next to it. There's nothing it can do about this. This minimum range is such a big deal, and there it goes. That's 9 villagers down, 10 villagers down, and no plumes down. Purple definitely had his revenge here. Blue with his shot. Ooh, that did land. One plumed archer did go down. Blue tries to repair it as well. Does get the repair in, but oh, not in time. And purple definitely did some damage here, as blue is going to go for a panic castle right now. As purple says, hot damn, that's a nice buffet for me. As blue tries to kill the plumes, kills his own villager instead. As purple is still sniping vills, he knows his castle cannot be denied. But he's gonna make blue pay for it, and blue is losing a lot of villagers right now. Gets the castle up nevertheless, as purple is still being annoying around the base of the castle. But oh, that was a great shot from blue. Finally has a bit of revenge here. Yeah, with that, purple is gonna have to back off now. Definitely lost a bunch of plumes there. Nice shot there. That's kind of what blue needed here to keep the plumes away. Good stuff. As for Lix, has made it to the castle age right now. Let's see, 55 villagers and fishing ships for Yo, only 45 for Lix. So yeah, definitely not having fish is definitely helping Yo, who is also Portuguese, so I wonder if Oregon guns might come out at some point. Let's check. Yep, there you go, Oregon guns. Anyways, Orange, who has been booming a little bit, is the first to make it to the Imperial Age. Am I correct in saying that? No, I'm not, because it's yellow. Never mind. Oh, yellow went to the Imperial Age to kill green. Never mind. We haven't really been paying attention to this side of the map. Yeah, so green is... Green's gone. Like I said, this was a matter of time. You know, he walled up the sides to slow down his opponent. But of course, you know, yellow is going to make his way through this wall sooner rather than later. And I hope that someone on Lix's team is going to be able to go to Imperial Age to deal with this. I think it's going to have to come down to gray here. Like, gray is the only one who has not really been hit in his town yet. So it's going to come down to him to defend. We got a nice shot in on the plumes as well. We're still running around raiding. Nice shot there, one for one. Might have been a delete from blue as well, so he can actually do the full amount of damage to kill purple's mangonel. Not sure what Yo was axing there as well. I think he's axing the monk. Like, yo, that's my relic. As predictably, yellow makes it through the walls and forcing green into another set of walls, which will go up. It will go up, but it's just stone walls, so it's not that big of a deal. Also, oh, there's walls in the north as well. Never mind. The walls are there. But yeah, green, of course, does not have the economy to defend himself. Only 38. Is not going to be an imp anytime soon. Needs some time to get back on his feet. So he's going to rely on gray, especially. who is Mongol. So, I mean, Mongol late game, very big potential as well. So, we'll see. In the meantime, Orange and Purple shifting their attention more to Blue, who is on his way to Imperial Age as well. He's making Rathas right now, which I guess are decent against Plumes. You know, I don't know, actually. Like, they have HP, but they don't have a lot of Pierce Armor. I really think Rathas should probably get another Pierce Armor. Like, they're really underpowered as is. Like, they're not as OP as it seems, honestly. Like, I saw Rathas in a few games, and I have not really been impressed so far. As well, Blue is going to switch to melee Rathas right now to take down the trebuchet. But look at that. Bam. I mean, these are Berserks with Chieftains, I'm sure. Let's see, do they have Chieftains? They do not. Nevertheless, still 18 attack. That's crazy. And a GG is called. GG is called. Green knows they can't hold on here on this side. They can't. Lix isn't in a position to really make military as well. Was just getting his boom started. I don't think Gray thought he was able to stop this pressure. And of course, Blue was about to die to this as well. Which would have been a mortal blow to the team. So yeah, G to the G. But man, what a fun little war was going on over there. I would call that the Boar War. That is a pun intended. That was fun, though. Alright, yeah, I mean, in the end, what saved Lix was the fact that he had a teammate right next to him, so that the teammate could drop a castle, and that, at that point, Ryo has to run. That saved Lix. The problem is that another teammate, who was in a similarly a bad position, was even in a worse position afterwards, because he was going to get ganged up upon by a lot of opponents at the same time. Yeah, and then trying to reboom at that point, it takes a while to get back into the game. And if you don't have that time, you know, if the rest of your team can't, you know, make anything to get, like, to support you and defend you for a bit of time, it's going to be really difficult to get back into the game. You know, and especially if Blue falls, then Gray is going to have to deal with pressure on the left side as well, while also having to deal with pressure on the right. You know, and then it's basically two players needing to reboom, one player who's almost done rebooming, one player who's boomed, but has to fight two fronts at the same time, up against a team that only has one player that needs to reboom. You know, it was going to be really difficult. Even though the economy difference wasn't that high, still though. Have a look at the KD. Wow, look at that ratio. That makes yellow look so good. But then if you look at the actual numbers, 21 kills, 2 losses, you know, not that big of a deal. One thing that I want to look at, you know, I mean, it's hard to tell now, but maybe we can look a bit at the villager kills. Looks like Lix lost 11 villagers in total. A lot of them will be from the Boar War. As for Yo, he lost 7 villagers. So yeah, even if Lix lost some vills to other things than just the Vill War, I think he lost some vills to Yellow as well. Nevertheless, yeah, Yo definitely ended up being in a better position team-wise than Lix, so there's that. Let's have a look at the APM spikes. Let's just get... hang on, let me just get rid of everyone, and we'll just look at just Red and just... Look at this. We can do this. We can compare the APM. This is when the Boar War started. Looks like Yo was the faster player, you know, in the end. Not that Lix can't be fast. I mean, this might also be a Boar War, actually. Look at this. Just look at the APM spikes here. This is pretty funny. Man, that was very entertaining. GG. Well, ready for the third one? Because, yes, we do have a third one. Let's see. Because all these games have a bit of a theme. The last one was the Boar War. What is this one going to be? Ah, I see. I gave the replays good names, so I know what's coming now. Alrighty, this one's going to go a bit later, I think. So if you want to see some late game shenanigans, that I think that's this game. If I remember correctly, but we'll have to see. Because, I mean, again, I don't know what happens. I don't know all that happens, obviously, but I do know some things here and there. So let's get into the third game here. Let me adjust the colors again, because it looks like Vivi... one game he is, you know, he's purple when he's not supposed to be purple. Now he's not purple, you know. And Paladin the same, you know, they keep messing up my color scheme. So I keep changing their colors here. There you go. I guess Paladin just prefers purple, and I guess Vivi prefers blue. You know, they do pick those colors quite often, you know, which they're free to do. It's an unranked team game after all. You can pick whatever color you want. But for us to spectate, this makes it a bit more, you know, it makes it easier to distinguish who is who. And what who's part of what team, because these games are so hectic already, for me to have to then also see what you know, what which color is which team at all times, that's gonna make it too complicated. So let's introduce the players, shall we? We'll just start with Yo here, who's red playing as the Tatars. Oh yes, Tatars, and I'm putting extra emphasis on that so you'll know. In the purple we have Vivi playing as the Huns. Oh yeah, he will like that. Let's see over here. We got Jibbitong playing as the Italians. Basically right next to Bear Koala here in the teal, playing as the Burgundians. Let's just finish up Yo's team. We have Doidi playing as the Vikings in the yellow. All right. As for the other team, we got Lix playing as the Chinese. Well, there you go. And right next to him, we got Blue, played by Paladin, is playing as the Burmese. Very nice. And last but not least, we got Gray, kind of hard to see there because the Townsend is the same color as the woodline. Any case, playing as the Turks. Interesting. You don't really see Turks that much on Nomad. I think they're all playing random, right? They're playing random Sif. I don't think they're Sif picking. I think they're just, you know, whatever Sif you get, that's what you play with. So you're probably going to see some unconventional, quote-unquote, picks on Nomad. Now let's just have a look at the positioning of the TCs. I think Yellow is gonna have a good game here. Also, as Vikings and a nice corner, he's gonna have a nice game, at least for now. Even though it looks like Lix is taking a Rhino that was pretty close to Yellow, so Yellow should probably get that Rhino if he can. Looks like Green knows. Does he know that Lix is there? I think he just saw that Rhino, decided to get it anyway. So. Might not have been an insidious motive this time around. As for Green and Blue, they're going to have the 2v2 against Red and Purple here. As you can see, they're quite close together. You know, I like... You know, it's kind of... Like, both teams have an advantage in the positioning. Like, for Green and Blue, Green is further away from the front, so he can probably get some more economy up, and it might keep him a bit safer. But as a result, Blue is going to have to deal with a two-pronged attack here. At the same time, though, Yo and Vivi here, they can attack Blue from two sides, but Blue can also split them up easily. So there's that. So they can't cooperate as easily as Green and Blue can. Yeah, so things to keep in mind. As for Gray, he has a similar situation to Yellow. He's probably nicely on his own. I think the Turkish player will like that because Turks really get their power spike in Imperial Age. That's really what their strong suit is. So they want to get there as fast as they can. You know, it's not like you don't have options in the meantime. Like, Janissaries are good in G-Castlades as well. I wonder if we're going to get to see those as well. But nevertheless. And then we have Bad Koala and Jibbitong. They're probably going to have a little 1v1 over here because they're very close once again. So yeah, that's gonna be fun. Let's see. We'll have to keep an eye out to see who's gonna win this. Now I'd say Bad Koala is lucky that his TC is on the south, not the north, because otherwise Orange could cut him off from his teammate Gray. And now Gray can always send help to Teal easily across this fort to help him. He can also expand to this other land if Orange blocks him out on this side, which is probably what's going to happen. Orange will probably wall around now, make sure that Teal can't get away from this little peninsula. And we saw how devastating that could be for Green in the last game. Not going to be any different this time around, trust me. Except that Teal can always run away now across this fort. At least if Orange doesn't wall him out. Because then you're really stuck in this little peninsula. Teal, though, has a villager bringing in a Rhino. He's trying to de-aggro it as well. One more hit and she goes down. And saved. Not blocked by the villager. Saved. There you go. Nice. Nicely done. Nicely done. The Rhino is saved. And now Orange won't have that one. Good stuff. It's all about that early game like that. As Blue is letting everyone know where half the enemy team is. More than half, actually. I guess Blue can see that. It's not Vietnamese. I guess he just scouted well. How does he know that Red has his DC here? And how does he know that Yellow has his DC on this side? That's kind of suspicious. We're not cheating, are we, Paladin? We're not cheating. Because I can't see him... Right, like, it's not like Blue scouted all of that. Like, let's look at Green scouting. Green doesn't know that Yellow is here either. How would I know that? We'll just call that sixth sense then. I mean, Blue can see. I can't see it from here either. He sees two houses. Maybe that might clue him in. Like he might think, oh, probably you see here. But I mean, that isn't necessarily the case, right? It's now Teal. Okay, Teal doesn't want to get walled in, and this is really smart from Teal. Like a lot of people, what they will do, right? They'll see this and they'll wall here because then they're like, oh, now I'm safe. The problem is you wall yourself in. It's much better to wall your opponent out of terrain. Like, yes, they can still come around, but it's much better than having them wall you in and make you stuck in a little arena of your own, cut off from any resources. And now Teal can still expand to this side, you know, and take all these extra resources that you can find over here. As we have Purple fishing in his little inland sea. Yeah, Vivi's gonna be happy about that one. Looks like Blue, yeah, he walls out Purple on this side. And let's see if Blue's gonna attempt to split the two up, you know, which would be a strategic advantage for him. But there's a lot of walling if he wants to do that. You know, if you create some military here, that would be good. Although this hill is gonna be important to control as well. It's important for Blue and Red, but especially Red, because his gold is right there. And Red doesn't really have any other gold right now. I'm not sure if he sees that one, actually. Let's have a look. He does not. He doesn't know there's gold right there, which is why he went to this unsaved gold. So we'll see. Any case, we got green to the feudal age now. I should imagine it's probably going to be some water play from him. Yeah, as you can see, making some galleys to contest the fish from his opponent. But for now, things have been rather mild and peaceful, you know, compared to the other games, certainly so. I mean, things might change. That might change quite more quickly than we would expect, but still. If Teal going on to the feudal age as well, quite late actually, of course. But of course, he didn't have as much food. Yeah, just simply not enough food. Also going to stone. Interesting. All right, so we're gonna go to stone as well. I wonder if that's just for towers or a castle. Teal can still delete this house and drop a castle right in the middle of Orange's town, which is definitely a possibility we need to keep in mind. We have an outpost now for Yellow for some vision. Very nice. Yeah, he's still just kind of chilling in the back. Has some fish. He's happy. He's making galleys as well. So it looks like Yellow's going to take on the water play role as well for his team. Let's see. Orange is making a fire galley as well. Not seeing anyone else do that. That makes sense, I guess. Although Orange still needs to be mindful. Like, a castle drop is always possible. Also, yeah, actually, he's thinking about it probably because he's also going to stone right now. Alrighty. How you doing, Dragon? Good to see you, man. Good to see you. Casting some white wolf pellets on Nomad. Nice little required buildings wall. And I noticed, like, pro players, they keep doing this. Two villagers for a market and one villager for a blacksmith. But I'm fairly certain that that means you have some TC idle time, because it doesn't complete the market in time, right? Is this a White Wolf Palace tournament or just a team game? I think it's just an unranked team game. I think they're just playing for their streams, probably. Like, it was just an unranked game. It didn't have a special name or anything like that. It was just called team game. So I don't know if they had like a White Wolf Palace tournament or anything like that, but either case, it's entertaining for us, right? It's entertaining for us. Which I should actually update the score, because it is 2-0 by now for Mr. Yo's team. It's, again, Mr. Yo, I mean, AOEII here with some galleys, definitely doing some damage here, killing some fish. Fish that Teal really needs, but won't have anymore now. So Teal is, if he thought about having some eco at all, that dream is now lost. Still, for all the proximity between the town centers, still not a whole lot of aggression between these four players. I'd expected a bigger war by now, as we have one archer harassing a builder. Alrighty. We got a sneaky barracks in the back here of Green's base. Something that he can see, actually. He got town watch, which is always a good idea in these kind of maps. Good to see. As we have Orange now, the first to drop a castle before Teal gets the castle. And Teal is forced to abandon his base. So in the end, the castle for Italian player does go up. Definitely helped by the fact that his aging up was cheaper, which means it's much easier to go to the castle age than it is for Teal, who is still 50 seconds away. And was planning to do the same thing, by the way. That's exactly what he wanted to do. Would have been more devastating if Teal had dropped that castle, actually. Yeah, here we go. Now, Teal will get to the castle age, no worries. But still, right? It's still annoying having to abandon your base. I'm not sure where he's going to go. He might decide to go to the other side and join Gray, who's just been sitting... booming a little bit here. Not seeing him go to water or anything like that. So he's just... he still has fish alive. Where's the fish for Gray? Let's have a look. Fish for Gray is in the north. Still alive. Not for long, though. I'm sure that yellow and orange are going to, you know, definitely deal with that in a bit. We got... Ooh, we got a fire galley under attack. Let's check that. We got... Ooh, we got green now with some navy as well. Some Chinese navy. With some micro, you could kill this fire galley, but it would be a lot of micro, and I don't... You know, you might not have the time to look at that. As we have blue now dropping a castle on the gold for red. I'm sure he would have wanted to drop that castle a bit closer to the middle here. And red is going to respond with a stone wall right now. He knows that gold is lost. He's not going to be able to get that. Still, does see the gold on the right now. So he can switch to that gold. He didn't see it earlier, which is why he took that gold on the hill. Castle now from Teal, another town center right next to it. So yeah, that's... Alright, it's alright. Genoese crossbowmen being created as well. Fairly strong unit against cavalry as well. You know, lacks the range of crossbows though. Kind of like a cavalry archer without the mobility. And of course the bonus against cavalry. Which is why they're so fearsome. We got some Hun cavalry archer now running into Blue's town. Something Blue's probably not too happy about. And at least one villager should go down here. There you go, very nice. Dodging the shot at the same time and finds the gold for green. Ooh, if only there were more cavalry archers here, that would be more devastating. And also having ballistics is probably important as well. Yeah, one villager down, second villager down as well. Luna here with some Arambi. Question is, who wins that? Arambi or cavalry archers? I'd say cavalry archers win the early engagements because they are more accurate. But it ends up being pretty even because Arambi do have a very high damage output. Yeah, in large groups, though, a Rambi can be devastating. If you bunch up your cavalry archers against a Rambi, you're going to have a bad time. Anyways, I think at this point, they probably know yellow is here. Yeah, they do know yellow is here. I mean, they knew it already. They X'd it. I'm not sure how they knew that. They didn't scout it, but I guess they had a sixth sense for this sort of thing. As, Green's just putting some pressure on. Kills one of the cavalry archers as well. Blue is here to put help with support. Yeah, Purple's just gonna have to run away. He wants to preserve that one lonely cavalry archer. And Yellow, who thought he probably was gonna have, you know, somewhat quiet boom time. Yeah, he's gonna have to defend himself. But we know Yellow can do that. The first game, he had a worse position than this, and he managed to get off quite well. So, and he still has fish, just like last time. So that's the main difference between Lix and Yo's team. Like, Yo's team wins water, and now they have fish, whereas Lix's team does not win water. Or hasn't in the last few rounds. Although, actually, the first game, it was still contested. We have Yellow trying to drop a talent now on his gold, but yeah, it's right under a hill. Something that the Mangonel will love, although the knight is killed, or at least deleted. I'm not sure which of the two. Downside, is it going to go up though? Blue is looking to deny that. Those Arambi, if they sit close enough, can kill all these villagers. Yellow running around a little bit, trying to split up his villages. But yeah, one-shotting these villagers as well. It's 99%. Downside, it goes up. Calculated. One scorpion doing not too much here. Oh, bueno. As we have Orange now at the receiving end of a castle drop. As we have a castle drop attempt from Teal in the middle. There's some Genoese crossbowmen as well, making it really difficult to engage with your Custodiers. There's a Mangonel here, though, to push them away. The Mangonel from Orange cannot engage the Mangonels from Teal because the Custodiers here are hanging around. And they will snipe that Mangonel if it gets too close. So the castle will go up, effectively splitting Orange's town in two. So Orange is getting a bit of payback here from what he did to Teal earlier. So now he's just going to have to go to Teal's old town and I guess split to both sides. Of course, the Mangonels can now safely take this town center. There's nothing that Orange can do about that. So, the Baton definitely been on the back foot here. At the same time, though, we got cavalry archers against Arambi. Now, if you micro this, it's okay. But as you can see, once the Arambi numbers start to increase, the amount of shots that they miss starts to decrease. Because there's more to hit in purple's army right now. Like, if it's just one unit, it's actually more difficult to hit that than five units, because you're likely to hit multiple targets at once. Yeah, as blue is happily raiding around here, can one shot these cavalry archers if all the shots hit. Yeah, purple can't quite engage this very easily. It's gonna be tough for Vivi to deal with this. And look at that, look at that. That's a missed shot. Two kills at the same time. That's what the Rambai do. That's why they're so devastating to cavalry archers. Because cavalry archers, they lack that HP, you know, in the defense, you know. And then don't have bloodlines right now. No melee armor. No pierce armor as well, because they didn't have get any upgrades yet. And tough. We have some villagers now from Orange being supported by Navy from... Navy from Yellow chased by the Janissaries here from Gray. As Orange knows he can't run with these villagers, he's trying to fight it, and Gray is trying to kill all these villagers. Poor Orange, he can't go anywhere. He can't go anywhere. He's relying on Yellow to keep these Janissaries away, but right now these villagers are just kind of stranded on the beach. Which is funny, because in Dutch, the word strand means beach. We call it strand. So when you're stranded on the beach, that's doubly funny. One for one here. Nice. Actually, two for one, because Teal lost his mangonel as well. Yeah. So it's still... Orange is still okay, but ironically, now Orange is the one stuck on the peninsula instead of Teal. Teal basically walled in Orange, even though that's what I thought would probably happen to Teal. So just kind of a change of events there. As Orange is trying to run away from these mangonels, but no sale. As Orange is also losing villages at the same time. These villagers need to survive. At this point, just split them up. Split them up. You need to split them up right now. Because you need one of these villagers to make it to the left side. Because Orange is stuck. He's stuck on this side. He needs to be able to expand with some economy on the other side. I think the villagers will get away, though. These Janissaries are... just a little bit faster than the villagers. Only a little bit, though. So if you split your villagers up, you won't be able to catch both. In the meantime, we have Red, who with that stone wall kept himself safe enough to now be able to castle drop in the middle of Purple's town. All right. Which is his ally. And I was excited for no reason. But this castle is actually important, because now Purple and Red can actually work together safely. You know, like this supply line can't be cut anymore. Which means Red can actually start supporting his friend here, who's still being raided by the Arambai. Arambai still being devastating, but they shouldn't be under a town center fire, especially not, when you lack some armor as well. And all the Arambai go down. That wasn't a good move there for Paladin. Certainly not. Especially as now battering rams come out, and you really wanted to support that. Because now, Purple can just fight these with villagers. Yeah, no problem. They have someone going to... is someone going to Imp, or did someone just... yeah, Gray actually make it to Imp, because Gray is the only one who hasn't really been molested so far by the enemy. And he's probably going to start putting some pressure on Purple now in the west, especially since Bad Koala is doing such a great job in the north and snuffing out Orange's villagers as well. Where's all Orange's economy? Is making a run for it. Orange is making a run for it. This is an entire economy on the run, you know. And of course, Teal is going to let his teammates know, like, yo, you should hunt this down. I wonder how much of this economy can actually go home and be saved. We haven't really talked much about Yellow and Green. Looks like Green dropped the castle on Yellow, but Yellow's still defending himself. Dropping a castle in the north, though. Mangonel is here. Knight to defend. Make sure you don't lose your villagers. Green trying to try to convert that, but will the Mangonel go down? Repair villagers just in time. Knight gets converted. The Mangonel does not go down, and I'm suddenly... well, this castle even going to go up? Three villagers is... three villagers just got down, and Yellow thought, nope, that's not going to go up. I need more villagers. It's sending more villagers to commit to this. Sending a villager to take down a Mangonel, knows it needs to go down. And Green is still being annoying, killing more and more villagers. 85%, 86. It will go up now. I hope so. Yellow still dodging a shot. Still losing villagers here. Jesus Christ. Oh, this castle cost a lot for Yellow. Yeah, Green, that one Mangonel got so much value just by microing it around a little bit. As now we have Purple, making his way into Blue's town as well. Which I'm sure Blue will not be happy about. The Arambai numbers just not high enough to stop this from happening. Only 9 Arambai on the scene, and most of them are not here right now. So, that castle does go up. In the meantime, cavalry archers are running all the way through Blue's town, as Blue is also... They tried to drop a castle on Red again, but I guess Red counter tower... Counter castle, I mean. I still got a castle up right in the... Yeah, actually, that castle was up earlier as well. At this point, Orange is just surrounded as Orange is trying to run. He's trying to run, but he's being chased by Turkish Cavalier. A unit that you don't see that often. As I guess Orange is going to have to run into Yellow's town and try to find some safety there. Now, Orange is pretty dead right now. Pretty dead. Has no town right now. No economy. Nothing to work with. So we'll see. It's going to come down to the rest of his team, who have admittedly a better position, as we have some Keswicks now stopping the raids from Grey. Because, of course, Grey is free hand. Now that Teal and him have conquered the east, Purple and Red's position got significantly worse. Significantly worse, because they can now be attacked from two sides, which is of course a big deal. The Purple, Purple is anxious about this. He knows that those attacks are coming, so he's trying to wall this up, but there's a hole there. There's a hole. This wall's good as nothing. And now there's Camels, and Camels counter everything that is here right now. Yeah, that's no bueno. That wall's not gonna go up so far. Oh boy, oh boy. Grey is sending in more and more cavalry. And the Tatar player can make his own camels as well. Has heavy camel, I think. So at least there's that, but still. Right now, numbers are what's doing it. Numbers are what's doing it. But the Hun player actually converted the camel as well. Of course, camels are the bane of Huns, honestly. They don't have a lot of options against that. Same time, we have some Trebs now trebbing down Yellow's castle. She's trying to repair this one and keep it up. But yeah, Yellow's town is starting to become more of a ghost town, which is kind of a problem for Orange and Yellow, because they can't quite get to the other side anymore now. It's Gray and Teal right there. So if their team starts to be pushed back on this front, it's going to get more and more difficult for them to handle. This might actually be a game where Lix's team is decidedly ahead. But the game is not over yet. The game is not over. Especially Yo and Vivi are still alive, technically. Yo also making it to the Imperial Age with a decent economy. Is getting more and more cashings out. But cashings still get countered by Heavy Camel. And Turk Heavy Camel is fine. You know, it's just fully upgraded Heavy Camel. You know, all that you need. Actually, they're missing their final attack upgrade. But that's coming in right now. We have... Ooh, interesting. That is Timurid's Siegecraft, which gives your trebuchets plus 2 range. Also, it allows you to make flaming camels. You're being attacked by a whole lot of camels and cavalry right now. Flaming camels have a bonus attack versus cavalry. You know, they're great against elephants, actually. So, you know... We'll see. We'll see. Let's see. And there you go. There you go. Yeah, I mean, I have to be fair. I knew this was going. But here you go. Flaming camels. Which, again, let's have a look at that. 20 base attack. 200 attack versus building. 130 versus war elephants. And 50 versus cavalry and camel. Like, these things do a lot of damage if you can explode it in the middle. Let's have a look. Like, Gray knows. He knows. He's running away from this. Send forth the flaming camels, as they said in the campaign. And I actually get to say it now. Let's go. Let's see what the difference that makes. Look at that. Bam! Oh, those are amazing shots. Look at that. Flaming camels OP. Gray's army is annihilated. That army was twice as big just a second ago. Flaming camels, man. Flaming camels, another one, right in the middle, splash damage to all these units, and suddenly Red and Purple are pushing back against Gray, who lost his entire mass. Jesus Christ, that was very satisfying. Wow, I can't believe I actually got to say the send forth the flaming camels thing. Who would have thought? Yeah, Red is making more flaming camels. Why not? If you have a winning strategy, you know, you stick with it, right? In the meantime, though, Yo's team is under a lot of stress in the west side as Orange forces up a castle to keep his villagers safe. But yeah, I mean, Yellow is trying to run, Orange is trying to run. I mean, at this point, you should just make some transport ship, my dudes. But I mean, where would you transport? Green and Blue are now in control of the north here. Gray is still in control of the east. Teal, of course, has the entire northeast sector to himself. It's Purple and Red. That's the only place they can go. And more flaming camels. Let's go. Boom, 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 boom. I mean, Purple, you should... Yeah, lead them into the flaming camels. There you go. Bam. Bam. I mean, you need to make sure you hit more than one unit at the same time. Look at that. Look at that. It's like a petard for enemy units. It's awesome. And suddenly, again, Gray's military count is super low. He's in pretty much in fully boomed Imperial Age, and his army is 16. Because he keeps losing his cavalry to the frickin' flaming camels. And that's what you call a flaming yawn. God, flaming camels are the best meme unit in the game. I agree, I agree. I am very happy that we actually get to see them, though. Yeah, you never get to see flaming camels because, well... Although, honestly, just a tip. If you're playing Castle Blood Automatic, CBA, and you are Tatars, you can make flaming camels from your castle. So why not, right? I mean, you have infinite resources. There's no reason not to spend them. You know, if you can't build buildings, right? Like, I was once in a situation, I only had castles, so I had to wait until they spawned for my castles, my cashiks, which are not a great unit. But I could make flaming camels, which is very nice if your opponent is spamming paladins. And look at that. Look at all the booms. These are heavy camels, and they're losing to cashiks right now. It's because of those flaming camels. They do so much damage. I really want to see the KD after this. I really do. It's going to be really good for red. As red and purple are slightly pushing back, but they're also being pushed back on the left now. Remember, green finished his conquest off the west here. You know, yellow and orange are essentially pushed away. Orange is down to 6 villagers, which are somewhere. I don't actually know where his villagers are right now. Yeah, I have no idea. Yeah, they realize. The flaming camels cannot save the fact that green and blue won the war in the north. And at that point, red and purple are all by themselves. Flaming camels or no. And how you doing, Zerba? Good to see you, man. Good to see you. You just missed the flaming camels. Look at them. Oh, and they actually made a difference. That's a lot of camel bodies, don't you think? Oh, man. Honestly, if Orange hadn't lost his battle in the north, right? If it had been a normal 1v1, Yellow might have been able to move here as well. They might have been able to control this. But yeah, Gray and Blue and Teal, they made the north completely inaccessible for Yellow and Orange. So as soon as they got pushed out of their main base, there was nowhere to run. There was nowhere to run. Like, they weren't able to kill Green and Blue, you know, early and on. Like, Blue, I mean, I guess Blue is kind of dead now. But I mean, like I said, right? That's what I said at the start. It was very difficult for red and purple to work together here. They were kind of far apart. And blue and green kept splitting them up as well. Now, blue got attacked from two sides, got destroyed. Yes, but green was completely unharmed, essentially. Used that to kill yellow. You know, and then now he can switch around and put pressure on red and purple from the other side. It's kind of what I predicted would happen. Of course, Gray had a free boom, and if it had not been for the flaming camels, would have overrun the Hun town by now. You know, like, camels into a Hun town is very difficult for the Huns to deal with, so yeah. And of course, Teal, and just so you know, Teal started out right here. Orange started out right here. In the end, Orange dropped the castle on Teal. Teal then went around, dropped the castle on Orange, and then Orange was the one being walled in by Teal, which is kind of ironic if you think about it. Yeah, you were stuck in Teal's old town. It's funny. That's what sometimes happens. You know, you're like, oh, I conquered your city. And then your enemy turns right around and besieges you in the city you just conquered. It happens. Actually, remember, that happened in the First Crusade as well, when the Crusaders took the city of Antioch in, I guess that's Syria right now. Or is that Turkey? It's right on the border there, right? They took the city after a long siege, but then immediately a Seljuk army showed up in the east and besieged their town. So they were stuck in a town they just conquered under their own siege. And then the only way that they actually won was by sallying forth, and it's so savagely attacking the Turkish army there that the Turks decided to make a run for it because they thought that there were more crusaders there than they thought. So they, you know, confusion that they were being surrounded. I don't know exactly the details. Just saying it was a victory nonetheless. In this case, though, not so much. Alrighty. Talita signed up for Virgo Cup 7. Awesome, awesome. Yeah, I'm expecting all you guys to sign up again for Virgo Cup, you know, because I want to cast everyone. You know, it's very important to me. Let me real quickly look at the KD. I really want to see what the KD is like. I guess the KD, it was alright, I guess, for Yo. I mean, I guess Camels still kill Kashyyyks and Cavalry Archers, so in the end, the KD for Gray, not the worst, right? But just one thing. Look at this. Look at the hobbles here for Gray. Yeah, if you can see that line. It's like, bam, goes down. Bam, goes down. Bam, goes down. It's flaming camels, my man. It's flaming camels. That was fun. Send forth them flaming camels, yeah. Yeah, and again, APM very high for all these players, obviously, because they're very strong. Good stuff. All right. Nico was in a decider game for LA4K's tournament. That's the only bans tournament, right? Slam versus Nikov. Well, good luck to the both, I guess. I will. I might check that out later. Then. I mean, I'm not casting it, obviously, but yeah, I guess I could watch the recording. And so, gotta keep doing my homework, right? Honing my casting skills, because only by watching pro players can I really learn the game at their level, because it's certainly not going to be for my own playing, unfortunately. You know, I think for now I will remain a, you know, as they say, a best sailor on the shore. And yeah, the best sailor stand ashore. That's it's a saying in Dutch, at least. I'm not sure if it's a saying in English. Yeah. Any case, I got one final, well, actually I have more White Wolf Palaces game, but one final Nomad game, at least, from then, to finish off this Nomad Bonanza, as I've been calling it. So if you don't mind me, let me go into the tap into the game here. Get that final replay. Because this one is also very messy, very messy. Let's see. Here we go. Let me queue that up. I have something to look at while I drone on about this 20-year-old game. And boom, there we go. Alrighty. Now, welcome to the fourth game. Let's see if Lix's team here can tie this up. I mean, I only have four games, so if they tie it up, it's just a tie. They played more games, but I decided to cast these four. Yeah, we'll see. As we have, yeah, or let's not do that, Orange. Let's not TC right next to Lix. I think Jibbitong probably, you know, I don't think he has a death wish like that. You know, to TC that close to Lix. Trust me, not a good idea. Not a good idea. We all know Lix after the 2v2 World Cup. He's pretty much a household name now. And it doesn't get more messy than a Lix game, trust me. It's pretty bad if you're at the receiving end of that. Very fun to watch for us, though. And perhaps this game will be no different. Now, if you don't mind me, I am going to change some colors around here, just for clarity's sake. I'm going to make Paladin blue again. And Vivi is going to be purple. There you go. That way we can see the team games. And now, see, now you know that this is not a team member of Lix. No, this is actually Vivi. So let's introduce the players. I already said Lix playing here in the green as the Sicilians. Interesting. In the orange, we have Jibbitong playing as the Mayans. The purple, we have Vivi playing as the, what is it, Malay? Yeah, it's Malay. Noobcaster. In the teal, we have Bad Koala playing as the Bulgarians. Almost said Burgundians, but I meant Bulgarians. In the yellow, we have Doidi playing as the Bengalis. All right. In the red, we have Mr. Yo playing as the Dravidians. Good stuff. Then in the blue, we have Paladin playing as the Japanese. And then last but not least, in the gray, we have Stray Dog playing as the Vikings. All right. It looks like everyone is pretty much on the right side of this map, which means that the left side is up for grabs, which heavily favors Lix's team in this case, because they have their town centers on the left side, so it's very easy for them to expand. Whereas if anyone of Yo's team wants to do that, they have to fight their way through enemy players. As blue is Xing, yellow's TC. Again, even though he can't see it, he did that last game too. Now I'm being suspicious a little bit that Paladin has some outside info here. Because there's no way. How does he know that? Like, look, this is what he sees. How does he know that? Like, his villager started there. It walked to the left instantly. You can't see any. I mean, maybe he saw this zebra move. Maybe, right? So a villager from Doidi walked past a zebra, it ran away, which looks different from it just walking around. Maybe he happened to see that in the fog of war, that's why he X'd that. Because he only X'd this town center, not like last time he X'd all three at the same time. You know, that was kind of sus. So let's give him the benefit of the doubt. He probably saw that. Which that's just being aware and paying attention, you know. That's what you're supposed to do anyways. As for the other town centers, I don't think anyone else can really see much. Like, Teal's scouting around a bunch as well. Hasn't found purple yet, interestingly. He doesn't know Provivia's right next to him, but he's going to find out sooner rather than later. Obviously, you know, Lix and Jebetong know about the fact that the other player's right there. Obviously, Lix is going to wall a bit forward because you do not want to be walled in by your opponent. Although, I have to say one thing. If you think you're trapping Lix, you're not trapping Lix. You're trapped in there with him. So, before you decide to do that and think that's a great idea, as Lix actually loses a villager now to Purple CC, of course, now they will know that Purple is right there, which is something that Teal should probably know about. Yeah, Teal still can't see this, but I bet Lix now said, yo, you're right next to Vivi, just so you know. Like, right next door. Wait, it's Purple... He might know about this. He might know about Teal. Yeah, I mean, at this point, he knows. He knows. I think he lost a goat here. Something like that. So he's just gonna be... They're just gonna be walling together. Look at that. Look at the cooperation. They're both making the same wall. See? This is what humanity can do when they're working together. When they're working together. And then making their own walls. You can't really, you know, you really need to make your own wall because it's too easy for your opponent just to lead part of their wall and then they can still break through when they want to. You know, so it doesn't protect you as much. But I like the walls here for Lix. Just in time too, because Orange now thinking about walling himself, but I think he just realized that that's not going to happen when his villagers started pathing to the left. That tells you someone has walled on this side. Also, nicely, the zebra on the right side of the fence. So now you have a little zebra pen on this side. Which Lix can definitely take, so we'll see how that's gonna go. Check the fish situation a little bit as well. We got a villager walled in by blue. Alright, so Yo's villager's walled in, but he's also walled himself in, so... Not like last time where he could get sniped, but... But he can't escape now and build another dock, which could be a problem later on. Bringing a boar in, very nice. Bringing a boar in at the same time, very nice. Else going on, we have one villager for Lix that walled himself in, is doing damage to a house now. Well, I mean, it's idling one of Purple's villagers and costing Purple some wood, so in the end, it's pretty sweet. We have, oh boy, we have Purple now going to stone, which should tell you one thing and one thing only, towers. Towers, because it's going to be difficult to go up the castle age with this kind of stuff. And wait! There it is! There it is! It's a douche! Sicilian douche, let's go. Sicilians built their town center really quickly as well, making them one of the better douche civilizations in the game. Because normally normally you use Persians because you have more HP, so you always win. If you don't have Persians, you have the same same TC HP, which means that during the building, your TC takes a lot of damage already from the enemy TC, if your enemy... You know, reacts to it. But Sicilians built their TC so fast that that is minimized. So now, at the same time, we have Purple, who is, very much losing this battle because he's not committing to it. So Purple is just going to let this happen. It's on the way to Feudal Age, though. Hopefully, within 40 seconds, can keep this down center up. Already down half the HP. I think he might... Oh, actually, Green is distracted now by the villagers down there. I think at 22 seconds, it's going to be fine. That's going to be fine. And Orange sees that, right? Orange heard about it from his teammate. Like, Lix is douching us. So, be ready. So, Orange is going to wall. He's going to wall. Lix is here being annoying as well as usual. This villager is walled in, but has the hill. Has the hill against Orange. Orange can't get to the hill as well. As the Green's forced to build the house a little bit, keeping these two villagers from Orange out at the same time. Looks like Green's villager is gonna win that fight in this little arena. Fight, who's gonna win? Hang on. Orange actually more HP. No, Lix's villager is gone. Alrighty. And now Lix kills the villager. Just look at that. This is his reward for winning that hand-to-hand battle there. That's his reward. As Lix's villagers are back in the house, but yeah, I guess gonna run away then. Well, in any case, this I guess this is happening. We have ourselves a douchey game. And that's not to mean douchebag, but just what it is. It's a douche. As Lex is still fighting with villagers, as be careful not to lose a villager. Nope, villager goes down. That's not so good for Lex though. He needs those villagers, you know, to build more TCs and douche more. As the TC for Vivi has gone down, forcing him out of his town right now. And let's see what Lex is gonna do. Because again, you know, they thought they had trapped Lex on their side in the north, but instead Lex is just gonna make their life hell. Remember also that Teal's on the other side, making sure that Purple can't really run anywhere. And Purple has no TC right now, so I guess Purple's not really interested in stuff like that. If he thought he was going to water, that's not going to happen now. Meantime, yellow and red just happily booming. Gray and blue also just happily, well, not booming, but going up to the cast slate. Fun stuff. As Lex decides to not run in here, there is a tower here for Purple, which makes things difficult. As Purple is perhaps still thinking about extending this tower rush. I mean, that is what he is on stone for, so we'll see. In the meantime, Lick still wants to break in here. He really wants to drop a tower or things like that on Jebatong here. And Jebatong really doesn't want to let that happen. More villagers going forward, though. That's a lot of villagers for just a tower, though. Looking at the wood count, looking at the stone count, you're Sicilians, you have 100 extra stone, which means you can get one TC dropped for free. As Orange is trying to desperately wall behind this and keep Green out as much as he can. Green now trying to break through on this side. Orange needs to pay attention to this. It takes a while to get through these palisade walls, those villages. Orange though, Orange. Not all the villages are attacking. Okay, Orange now responding to this. Let's see, stonewalling it now as well. Yeah, that's going to take a lot longer. But in the end, Lex doesn't have to get in here. He just needs to get close enough so that the TC ranges Orange's TC. I think if he kills this little corner, it's just enough. Like, that's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe? I don't have any range indicators, so it's hard for me to see. Maybe this, if he gets this one, it might be enough. Well, let's see. Yeah, he's gonna try. Yeah, he's so doing that. You know, Jebatong is like, oh yeah, I'm walling him out. You know, why is he trying to break through stone walls? That's not gonna work, right? That's not gonna work. I'm gonna be okay here. As he's going up to the cast slates right now. Yeah, see, he's walling behind. He still thinks that Lex wants to get through. I think Lex is just gonna build a TC right here. Let's see. Are you gonna try to break through stone wall? I mean, you do have bonus versus stone walls. No. Yeah. See? There you go. There's your TC. There's your TC. Orange probably thought, aha, I kept him out. Look at these walls. And then, this TC just laughs at that. There you have it. Now, this TC is pretty bad because it's not on a wood line, which means you can't take any wood safely, which is, of course, not so good for Licks here, as we have, we have some stuff going on in the south as well. Look at that. We have blue building a monastery and a siege workshop right next to red. Red, of course, yo, is going to wall that out. Also towering this place, which is going to kill that villager. There you go. That's the end of that. No shenanigans for you, Paladin. We have a castle as well dropped on, well, close to Paladin's town by Doity, which will keep these resources safe. And, of course, provide a nice little launching pad to attack from. In the meantime, though, we have Vivi with his towers, who has just towered all around Teal's base. And Teal's guess still alive. His town looks very cramped. It actually looks like a real town. You know, the streets are actually pretty normal size. You know, buildings close together. This is what towns look like. Not, like, spacious like this. As the TC obviously did go up, and Orange made it to the castellate, you know, by repairing his TC, of course, very important. And there you have it. A second douche from Lix. I mean, he technically still has 100 stone. He could do it again if he wanted to. I mean, it's probably the most useful that he's going to be right now because, well, he doesn't have any wood. As now, yeah, okay. Orange has the stone for a castle. He's going to drop a stone right next to his DC. That will definitely kill this DC for green. So that's the end of the douche for now. Yeah, I mean, you're still making Orange waste a lot of wood, so I guess it's worth it still. As green is just using his villages right now. No economy from Lix, you're gonna see this game for sure. As said, Teal is migrating with some villagers to the south. Purple can't quite do anything. Purple did rebuild his TC finally, almost where his old TC was. And Purple's gonna have to relocate some of his villagers. But yeah, these towers are walled in, so yeah, this gold is no longer accessible either. And again, this is what tower players do. They keep towering. Wherever you go, more towers will happen. As, oh, a nice little trap here from Teal, walling this up so that he can actually kill these Vratas from Duty. Very nice. And not so much happening on the front, just the castle there. Yo, has killed this forward, also walled it in pretty much. And this villager stuck as well, so good stuff. And it was just a suggestion, Lix. Jeez, I know you're Sicilians, you know. He can do this 3 times, because he has 300 stone to start with, but to actually do it 3 times as well, well, there you have it. The Vivi, if he thought he could have another town center, not so much. And where do you go now as the fat dragon? We have a little DC here from Yo, who broke out of his little pen there to get out, and is going to build one villager DC on the left side to have some economy expansion. That's very good. Yeah, purple. Purple's gonna have to run. Also, purple does not have the wood, nor... Well, does have the stone, but doesn't have the wood to build another DC. So he's gonna have to be chopping some wood for now. Again, Lix did the damage. But at this point, he's gonna have to get the hell out of here at this point. I think it's time to send some villagers to the west here. And maybe actually TC and live for, you know, for real. Instead of essentially vandalizing your way through enemy's territory. Oh, as we have the Arthas now engaging against the knights and killing all the knights as well. I mean, they have the same attack and HP as a knight. Same melee armor. Technically, they can win against knights. They also can switch to ranged mode whenever they want, so I guess so. We have a monk push now from Paladin here into Yo's territory, who really wants to ram down this wall. Isn't ramming right now, but whatever. Steel's down is still a mess. We have Lix taking down this tower from Purple, which Purple really doesn't want to, he doesn't want Lix to take it down. He's trying to rush it down, but Lix, of course, walled himself in so he can take this tower out easily. Very nice. And if Teal deletes his house, Lix can actually escape. Can actually escape and maybe go to the left. As Purple... Well, actually, I say that, but Purple is pretty much walled in Teal's town completely. As Teal's... he's moved to the south to safer pastures for sure. Man, what a mess it is up here. I mean, just look at this crap. Jesus Christ. It's so messy. Now, the question is... We're all asking, is Lix going to do it again? And he's going to stone. Go figure. But Orange is wise to this time. Orange is not going to let Lix just sit on stone and just happily eat all the stone in the world. Lix is starting to lose some villages here as well. Wait, is Purple going to TC do Lix now? He has the wood for it. He has the wood and the stone. Is he going to do it or is he... No, actually, no, he has a TC over here. He might have been thinking about it, though. That was a lot of villages to send to the right. But I guess he decided maybe it's worth more if I get some economy going. And Lix... giving up on the whole douche idea, I guess, for now. Doesn't have the stone for another TC, so he's kind of stuck here now. In arguably a worse spot than he was before, because at least he had wood before. And now you're being hounded by Mayan-plumed archers. He's going to need some help soon here. In the meantime, though, the Narata is getting converted by blue. That's a lot of conversions, and yellow losing a lot of his units here. Which, yeah, some free units now for Paladin to use. Let's say Teal's slowly expanding his way south to gray. A gray and blue, it's going to come down to gray and blue. They need to push on, need to get a push going on Doidi and Yo soon. Because, I mean, Orange is going to be able to boom back into this game. Teal is trying to, but he's still on the front line. Purple and green are similar position, although green is still in Dark Age. So he's not going to be able to do much. Interestingly though, green is fishing. He is fishing. I haven't really talked about water whatsoever. I'm not actually sure who won that. Looks like Yo's team won. But nobody really has fish. So I guess in the end, it's kind of like a nobody really won this kind of situation. Alrighty then. We have Plumed Archers raiding Teal's town. Teal not very happy about that. And they're not strong enough to one-shot villages. But now they are. 12 Plumed Archers should do the trick. They're running right through 2 TCs. This is ballsy, though. This is ballsy. I'm not sure if that's the right move. Could have just run around it, but I guess not. I guess the short way is the right way. And so Gray is going to run away with his villagers as well to try to preserve as many as he can. Yeah, so Orange is not going to get to raid those. But he can't sit there and force Gray to make something to defend himself. At the same time, we have a castle attempt now from blue, but that castle is not going up. The Ratas with their ranged attack stopping the village from doing that. It's an important moment. Is this castle going to go up? Because it kind of has to go up now to defend the east side of blue's town. Because otherwise, yellow is just going to keep dropping castles here. I think that castle is going to go up as the Ratas from yellow, who were converted by blue, are now being used against the plumed archers, which are... Yeah, I guess the Blue Knights are going to have to run away. Of course, Blue doesn't have ballistics, because why would he? Yeah, the attack from Blue hasn't really worked out so far. And he's just defending himself a bit. Converting as many Ratas as he can, gets one, but then that gets shut down. Oh well. In the meantime, let's see. Look at Lick's situation. Bad. Lick's situation bad. Has one villager in the west, though, so technically, he could still live, maybe. Attacking a Manganel on the other side that is attacking his town center. He kind of has to. He has to do something here. What else can he do? As he's trying to drop a dungeon, actually makes it to the feudalates as well. Now, the dungeon will push away the plumed archers for just a second, so he's sacrificing some villages to get that up here. I think that will get up. That will get up. At least that will push the plumed archers away for now. Has the range to also attack Manganel, so at least there is that. I think Orange is probably gonna run away now. Man, that dungeon doesn't do any attack, does it? Ah, plumes. Wait, are we having some conversions here? Looks like blue again converting as yellow's trying to drop a castle in the middle of at the edge of Graystown. Is that gonna go up though? 85%, 86, 89, 92, 93. Village is still building. That is gonna go up, isn't it? Is it 99? Yep, that goes up. That goes up. That's a bad castle to have. And now a lot of monks for blue will go down if they try to run away from this. Yeah, they have to kind of stick to the base here. Yeah, they can't run away. They're too slow. It's never gonna happen. And as a result, Teal is going to have to run away, but a lot of his villagers as well. His town center is going to get denied for now. Now, luckily, lots of expansion room on the west. You know, it's not like Yo's team has really expanded to that side, but the eastern part of the map is definitely Yo's team's. Plus. As... Poor Lex is stuck in a tower. He can't go anywhere. The plumes are just sitting at the base of it. The town center is down. All Lex can do is basically fight, and that's not going to help him either. So he's just splitting up his villagers, forcing them to chase multiple groups, but that's just not going to happen. Purple also walling, making sure these villagers cannot escape, and Lex's economy is going to be terrible. The question is, where are most of his villagers now? I'm just trying to click, but I guess there's still a villager here somewhere. Yeah, the villagers... That's two-thirds of his economy, actually. His fishing ships and villagers right there. As yeah, the villagers are getting destroyed. And that leaves Lix with two villagers. One of which is over here building a TC. And there you have it. Lix is gonna reboot. Now he still has fish for now, but I guess not for long because Orange has found that. He's gonna take those docks out. Of course, Red could just send that fire ship to the west to kill the fish. And Lix really needs those fishing ships. Really needs them. I think he should send his fishing ships to the west. Maybe that's a bit safer. Although, again, Yo is making some fire galleys to take out the fish here for blue. Kind of a big deal. That's just... It looks much better for Yo's team at this point. They're all... Most of them going to Imperial Age as well. I mean, gray and blue. It's really going to have to come down to gray and blue here. Paladin and Stray Dog. They need to hold. Like, if they can't carry, then the team is lost. They need to hold against yellow and red somehow, as they're both pushing further and further land inward. More and more castles are being dropped by these two players. Teal's town is, not much left of that. He's actually still has villagers in here mining gold, you know, and they're kind of stuck here as well. And as long as purple allows this, I guess they're safe, but not going to last long, as purple is now going to really get back into a boom, getting a third town center up as well. Good stuff. Teal is, it has been forced to go further and further west. Has 58 villagers, so it's not too bad. But if you compare it to the purple is 65. And is, that's steadily growing as well. As all eyes are now on the front. As the yellow player just keeps getting more and more stone. Keeps getting to drop more and more castles here. And now that his northern flank is pretty much secure. All he has to do is push further and further west. And gray and blue are going to have to hold that on somehow. And more castles being dropped. They're like, what do you do in this situation? What do you do? I mean, you're gonna have to hope. Hope that Teal and can get back into the game soon enough. I mean, you know that Lex is not gonna be able to get it back into this game anytime soon. It's not, there's no way. I mean, he actually has the food to go castellate almost. Which he could do. That's what he might... He might be idling his DC just to do that, actually. Elite Berserk coming in as well for Gray. Probably figures that is the best unit to make against those Ratas. But probably not so good when plumed archers are around as well. That's the danger. Orange, as the third player here, he actually has military, something that Teal does not. He's just making villagers. He has to be greedy right now. And has to hope that Gray and Blue can hold on. But can they? Samurai. Who's making Samurai? Ah, Blue's making Samurai. Well, Samurai are pretty good against any unique unit, honestly. Except Ulrumi Swordsman, apparently. Apparently, Samurai lose to Ulrumi Swordsman, which is the Dravidian unique unit. Which you might actually see if Yo decides to make them. He is making them. Well, you'll see. You'll see. Samurai lose to this. It's crazy. Trust me. They lose to these freaking Ulrumi Swordsmen. It's crazy. Should not happen. Does happen, though. It's because of that splash damage. Although, right now, he's just sniping the monks. Because Blue has been very annoying with those monks. Converting a lot of Darthats, actually. We're now holding on, but yeah, Barret is pushing further and further to the west. See, now I have Orange as well with a castle. It's a situation getting critical as Gray is using his trebuchet against the plumed archers. Because why not, right? Why not? Oh boy, oh boy. Let's see, look at purples, just booming. Teal, just booming. Green alive, but on the way to castellate. Like I said, that's what I thought he was doing. Idling so he could go to castellate. But yeah, now you get these Dravidian Ulrumi swords. Which, if they have Woods Steel, they ignore melee armor. And that is gonna be quite the doozy to deal with. These units are insane right now, trust me. If you don't have archers or siege to kill these, they are insane. Although right now, So I did say that they would lose against Samurai, which they do. I mean, they would win against Samurai, which they do one-on-one. And even in groups, because of the especially in groups, actually. Because of the splash damage. It's just they already did all those hits against the Monk, so... The Samurai were able to get their damage in. Because Samurai, of course, have higher attack than the Ulrumi Swordsman because of that unique unit bonus. That's definitely a thing. As Red wants to drop a castle, but that castle is not going to go up unless that castle gets destroyed first by Blue. Now Blue is going to have to move further and further to the west, and that's the thing. Defending is so difficult. Like, you keep having to rebuild town centers and farms, which is a lot of extra resources that you have to invest. Resources you can't invest in the front, which even makes that snowball worse and worse. Now you have more capped ramps coming out from the... From the Mayan player. Castle going down for Gray, who is still trying to build up one villager castle up here, which is probably not going to go up. It's starting to look kind of tricky here. Especially once Purple joins the fray as well, which Purple is almost at a level that he can do that. It's 115 villagers for Viv. He's on the way to Imperial Age as well. For Malay, he's going to be there in no time as well. Think we're looking at the deciding victory here, and yeah, there you have it. The GG is, well, it's not set, not called, but I'm sure they said it afterwards. The GG, and it looks like Yo Dream takes the set. 3-1, even though this was not a tournament, it was just for fun. At least, I don't know if it was a tournament, but I don't think so. Either way, though, good stuff. Good stuff. I mean, Licks and Shenanigans definitely delayed, a bit of Orange, but especially Purple, was definitely delayed by Licks. The problem was that Purple, at the same time that he was being douched, also really made Teal's life miserable. That was a big problem. Because now Teal, who is the comparable player to Orange here, was far behind Orange. Orange actually had army, allowed him to basically brutally murder and slaughter Licks's villagers on this side. And then also make life miserable on this side with the plumes. And that really tipped the balance in favor for Yo's team, which was already kind of winning because Yellow and Red, they were pushing into Gray and Blue's base. Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying it's because of the Rathas. I mean, definitely the elephants joining with the extra pierce armor and armor is certainly helping a lot as well. But yeah. Teal, he was trying to reboom, but as you can see, Purple is just ahead of Teal. And then, of course, once Lix was pretty much dead, there's not much that Lix can do beyond just trying to reboom. That's all you can do, really. You have to be greedy and try to get as many villagers out as you can. And hope that your team can buy enough time. But as you can see, the front was about to break here. Gray was about to lose these castles. Critical economy in the middle. And then also, what was Gray going to make against this? Like, you can't go Arbalest. Because the Ratas and the Elephant Archers will absolutely destroy you. But if you are infantry, then there's plumes. So it's like, there's no good option, really, for the Viking player here. Same Japanese, they have all the options, really. They could have gone skirmishers against this, but then you can easily switch the Ratas to melee, which will be a problem. I guess skirms would be the best option against this, honestly. Like, you kind of have to do something. Like, at least skirmishers technically counter all of this. Except the Ratas when they're melee, because then the minimum distance. But still, you know, it's really easy for either one of these players to add some sort of melee unit. Like, Orange can add some eagles. Or you can get some cavalry out from the Bengali player, you know, if you need them. Or again, the Ratas can be melee as well, so it's a tough one. And also, these Urumi swordsmen making it impossible to go samurai. Trust me. Once they have that charge bonus, let's see if we can find one that still has the attack. Well, I guess we're not going to get to see that then. No? I guess capture rate hasn't updated that yet. You can see it for the Custelier, but I guess not for these Urumi swordsmen just yet. And you should be able to see it for this one. This one is a new one, so it definitely not didn't attack anything. So, it's alright though. Let's have a look at the statistics. Bit of KD here. Yeah, poor Lick, 61 losses. That's all those villagers that got killed at the end. Yeah, he really didn't play a bad game with the douching, you know. But in the end, he wasn't able to slow down his opponents as much as their opponents were able to slow them down. Of course, maybe if he had sent some of his economy back to the west earlier, might have been a bit better, but... Yeah, the thing is, if you do that, that also makes your attacks a bit worse, you know, when you, makes it worse when you try to, still go on with your douches. You know, you really need the villager. You need to commit to it as well. Doing half of half is, I don't know, doesn't really work usually. Economy-wise, yeah, as you can see, economy for teal and green, much worse than for orange and for purple. And that really was the deciding factor. If Lix had been able to douche orange as well, and that would have been a bit different, right? If Orange had also been delayed, then this would have been a different game. But as things stand, it was better for Yoast here as well. Anyways, that was fun. So yeah, G to the G.